Google just made one of their craziest releases yet, which allows you to edit any photo with just a prompt. The craziest part is it's completely free and only takes a few seconds to generate. Today, I'm going to show you exactly how to use it and to turn those images that you're going to get from Nano Banana into fully AI-generated videos. But before we get started, be sure to hit the subscribe button down below so you don't miss out on more AI tutorials just like this one. Now, let's get into it. To start off, we're going to log in to Google's AI Studio. Over on the left-hand side, you're going to see this bar, and we're going to go ahead and click on the Generate Media tab. Here, you're going to see some different models, and the Gemini Native Image Model is the Nano Banana model, which we are going to be using. So go ahead and click on this. This is going to open up a chat box, and this is where we're going to be using our prompts. In this video, we're going to test out with three different prompts just to see how good this model really is. First, I need a photo that I can use to kind of test out some different prompts and edits. So I got this photo that I generated in Midjourney, and I'm just going to bring this over to Google's AI Studio and drop it in the little chat box. So for our first test, what we're going to try to do is change this girl's hat color from the dark green to a bright red. So all we're going to do is type change this girl's hat from green to red and hit run. As you can see, it responds pretty quickly, only taking a few seconds to generate. And here's the photo result we got. As you can see, it's pretty good. Her face stays consistent. The rest of her body seems to stay consistent, the background, but the color of the hat did change really pretty seamlessly. Now, what I really like about this model is that it's kind of like ChatGPT in the fact that you now have a bit of a conversation going. So I could go ahead and ask the model to make another change without dropping in the same photo again. All right, my first test went pretty smoothly. So now we're gonna try something a little bit more complex. Currently, we have this model standing in the middle of like a grocery store setting. So I'm going to see if we could get this girl to be standing outside in New York City. So I'm just going to type change this girl's setting from a grocery store to be standing outside on the streets of New York City. Then same thing, we're just going to click run. And once again, it did a pretty good job. As you can see, our girl has the same pose, same red hat, same outfit, face. Everything's really consistent except for the background. Now she's outside on the streets of New York. I will say, I feel like, honestly, just because of her pose, this looks like not the most realistic. But I think it still looks super good, and it's kind of crazy that it was able to generate such a good photo so quickly. For our third and final test in Nano Banana, we're going to try something even more complicated this time. Now we're going to have this image that we already kind of played around with. We're going to try to add another character to be standing with this girl and change the setting all within one prompt. So I'm going to go back over and grab this photo that I generated in Midjourney. I'm just going to go ahead and screenshot this. And I'm going to bring that over to our chat box. And I'm going to say, add this man to the photo with the girl that I uploaded. Have both of them sitting on a picnic blanket in Central Park. All right. Let's see if we can do it. We're going to go ahead and hit run. This one is definitely much more complicated, so I'm very curious to see how this turns out. Okay, let's see. We click on the photo. All right, this is looking pretty good. So we have the girl in the red hat, her outfit's the same. I will say, I feel like the face maybe changed a little bit. Let's do a quick little comparison. I don't know. What do you guys think? Maybe leave a comment down below. I feel like she's giving very Instagram model in this, and it looks a little photoshopped. And I actually think that in this other photo it gave us, she looks much more like realistic. She has a shadow over her face. So I'm gonna say it actually kept the character pretty consistent. And then for the guy, he has his same like bottle of champagne, glass of champagne. Funny enough, the girl has her bag from the grocery store. The guy's the same outfit, the Nikes. I would say his face, I would also say it kept the character very consistent. As you can see, they're in New York City. It looks like they're in Central Park. They're posed pretty appropriately for having a picnic. Overall, I'd say I'm pretty impressed. Overall, I think Nano Banana really does live up to the hype. As you guys saw, we got some pretty awesome generations from it with some pretty simple prompts. So, as promised, now I'm going to show you guys how to take those images we just generated in Nano Banana and turn them into fully AI-generated videos where the character will actually be able to speak. So first off, we're gonna go ahead and just choose one of the images we downloaded from Nano Banana to turn it into a video. So I'm gonna scroll up and I'm gonna choose this photo of the girl standing outside of New York City with her red hat. And all we have to do is click this little download button at the top. We're gonna head over to HeyGen, which is linked down below in the description if you guys wanna go and click on it and follow along. But on the Home tab, under Create Something New, they have a ton of all of these awesome features. If you guys wanna learn about any of them, we have a ton of tutorials on our channel going over all of the features. If there's one that you see that there isn't a tutorial on or that you just wanna learn more about, be sure to leave a comment down below and I will do my best to create a video around it. But for this particular use case, we are going to be using photo to video with Avatar 4. So go ahead and click on this. Here on the left-hand side is where we are going to upload our photo that we just downloaded from Nano Banana. All right, now that we have our girl uploaded over on the left, over on the right-hand side is where you can go ahead and upload your script. We have a few different options when it comes to this. What you could do is type out your script. If you're going to type out your script, you will be prompted then to select a voice down here. Or you also have the option to upload audio, or you go ahead and record your own. For this tutorial, I'm going to go ahead and upload my audio. So you're going to be prompted to add audio. Then if you go down here, you're going to see a custom motion option. Essentially, what this is you can prompt the character to do certain movements, such as wave at the camera, throw up a peace sign, kind of whatever you want. It is worth noting, though, that it is still in beta, so you might not always get the exact movement that you were hoping for. So that being said, we're just going to skip that for this tutorial. And then you're going to see some more options down here. You're going to see that you could export faster, or you could export at quality for 2x the cost. So faster, this is going to cost 30 credits for every 1 minute of generations. Quality, double the cost, it's going to cost 60 credits for every 1 minute of generations. Faster is kind of if you're doing more simple things. This is going to be totally fine for you to use. For example, in this case, we're just having her speak to the camera. So faster, no big deal for using it. If you want a little bit more precision, if you're doing something a little more complex, you really want her to do like this certain type of movement, quality is probably the better choice for you. Then over here on the right-hand side, you can change the different export quality you want to do. We are always going to export in 1080p, which is the best quality. Then we're just going to go ahead and click Generate Video. All right, and here's our final result.
Girl, it's always been New York or nowhere.
As you can see, the lip sync is so good. The taxis are moving in the background. There's people walking in the background. I will say, maybe you noticed at the beginning of the video, The water bottle is like so awkwardly high in her bag. This is just due to the photo that I uploaded. That is my fault. As you saw when we were doing it in Nano Banana as well, the water bottle was pretty high up, which makes it look a little unnatural. So that's on me. But other than that, like, the lip sync looks fantastic. Her movements are super natural as she's reading the script really as someone would actually say it. So super satisfied with these results. If you weren't, though, I'm going to show you guys a quick trick on how you could go ahead and fix this without having to update or kind of like re-upload everything that you just put into HeyGen. What you could actually do is click on these three buttons over here and then just hit edit as new. So this way you don't have to, like I said, re-upload the photo, re-upload the audio. You could just go ahead and try generating it again if you weren't happy with your original results. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to check out the description down below for some links to sign up to HeyGen and to check out some of our other awesome videos on this channel. If you haven't already, be sure to hit that subscribe button and leave a comment down below of what type of video you guys want to see next. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.